to Washington. I mean, I just got you broken in as a friend. I don't make friends that easily.
Oh, I know.
Well, I know you know.
Okay, we're just looking at it this way. You're gaining a husband.
Well, do I get to enjoy the perks, too?
No.
Yeah, that's right. Nick! What?
Sorry, ladies. I've got a life, too.
Come on, this is her unofficial bachelorette party. You don't want to send us away empty-handed, do you? I mean, I've been coming here a long time now. Come on.
Certainly not.
Oh, there is nothing more attractive than a man who is sensitive to a woman's needs.
Lovely.
There we go, ladies. To a happy life and a woman's needs.
Oh, bless him.
Okay, I think it's time we let Nick go to bed.
Listen, I gotta do a little business in the ladies' room. Could you go get the car and meet me out front? It's okay, Mama. I'll just be like three and a half minutes. No, five.
Okay. All right, thanks for the drinks, Nick.
Lori, we're locked up out front, so you're gonna have to go out the back.
Okay. Behave.
No. So, Nick. Mm-hmm.
Me! Yeah. I was looking at you in the bar. And you were looking at me. Yeah, you're looking at me now, no, aren't you? Yeah. You like that? Yeah. Yeah. I just want to kiss you. I'll do it all myself. I just want you to kiss me. I'm not gonna take my hand away. If you make a sound, I'm gonna slit your throat to the back of your neck. Yeah.
Shh. Shh, it's okay. It's okay, you were just dreaming. Was it the same one? It's okay. Our stuff's here.
Good.
Yeah. That goes upstairs, Alan.
Oh, can you please be careful with that?
Relax, lady. We're professionals.
No, I know. It's just that it's an antique.
Lady, everything we move is an antique. We're not responsible for that. Article 17 of your contract.
Our first meal in our new home. Hope you're not disappointed.
Oh, no. Are you kidding? It's terrific.
I'm gonna try and get all this stuff put away tomorrow while you're at work.
Hey, don't kill yourself. We're gonna be here a long, long time.
I hope so. Mm-hmm. I love this house.
Yeah.
I love you, too.
I love you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
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 Okay.
Yeah.
Hey.
Are you all right? He didn't hit you, did he? Are you all right?
Oh, no, no, he just scared me a little.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
A great way to welcome our new neighbor. You are, aren't you?
Yeah, Lori Peterson.
Hi, Helen Schmidt.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you.
So where'd you move from?
Chicago.
Wow, Chicago. Why'd you come here?
Well, my husband had to transfer out here for work.
I wish I could travel. Are you working here too?
Yeah, mostly I do illustrations for children's books, but Tom, my husband, talked me into doing one for myself, so I'm trying to write a children's book right now.
That is great. I bet your kids really get a kick out of that.
We don't have kids yet, so.
I didn't mean to. I am always doing that. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine.
Well, we have two, Rocky and Dylan. She's a girl.
Oh, sweet.
Mom, I could take Wolf for a walk.
That would be Rocky. No, honey, you'll have to wait till you get a little older for that. Go on, go in the house. I'll be there in a minute.
Helen!
That's Carl, my husband. I better go. Anyway, it's nice to meet you. If there's anything I can do, just holler, okay?
Hey, thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice Bye. To meet you too.
Honey, I got an email. I gotta go to Los Angeles for 2 weeks.
What?
Yeah, it's some kind of an emergency. They say it's the last time, though.
Right. When?
Monday. You'll come with me. Yeah, it'll be great. We'll have some fun.
No, I can't come with you. Monica's flying out, remember?
Oh. Yeah, I forgot. Can't she come another time?
No, she can't come another time. She's flying out here for work. You knew about this. We planned this.
Yeah, I know, but... Well, there's nothing I can do. I gotta go. I wish she'd come with me. I'll only be here alone.
Well, obviously you can't get out of it, so... Jeez. I'll be fine. Well, Monica's coming up. I'm sure she'll take care of me.
You sure?
Yeah. Oh, I met our neighbors today.
Oh, yeah? What are they like?
She's really sweet. I really liked her.
Yeah.
I haven't officially met him yet, though.
You'll be okay while I'm gone?
Stretch, take your arm across, and stretch, take your other arm across, and...
Morning.
Hi.
Oh, I'm not interrupting you, am I?
Oh, no, I was just trying to get some exercise. Who was it that said beauty is pain?
I don't know, but I always thought beauty was luck. Losing beauty, that's pain.
Come on in, please.
Okay.
Can I get you something to drink?
Sure. Oh, I love those colors you got in there.
Oh, jeez. It's kind of disorganized, but it's coming together.
Oh, it looks great.
Thanks. So, what can I get you?
Whatever you're having is fine.
Okay.
I keep meaning to start working out. Carl says I'm getting fat. I just can't seem to find the time.
Oh, you know what? I'm sure two kids keep you busy enough, right?
Yeah, they do. That's no excuse. So, how are you finding the neighborhood?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
I hope all the other Thanks. Neighbors are as friendly as you.
I'm certain they would be if you could find one.
Very true.
Oh, the reason I came over was to invite you and your husband over for dinner tonight.
Tonight?
Oh, Carl insisted. I told him what happened with Wolf, and he says, don't take no for an answer.
Well, I'll talk to Tom as soon as he gets home, and...
You have to come. I mean, we would really love it if you would. He's dying to meet the both of you, and He loves to entertain.
Well, I guess I can't say no then.
Great. Thanks. Oh, is 6 okay? Carl likes to eat at 6.
Yeah, that should be fine.
Oh, good.
Come on, honey. We don't want to be late.
Whoa. Hey. No religion, no politics, all right? I want to make a good impression.
Thank you.
Who's at the door?
Oh, come on in.
Hey.
Okay.
Hey.
You must be Tom.
Yeah, hi. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Laura's told me so much about you.
Did she? So, how is everything?
I think we're a little underdressed. I'm sorry.
Don't be silly. You look wonderful.
Oh, no, you look great.
It's washable. I got it at Sears. Anyway, I'm just going to put the baby down, and dinner's almost ready. Would you like a drink? I made martinis.
Yeah, it's great. Yeah,
yeah, here, let me give you a hand.
Okay. Right. Have a seat, Tom.
Thanks.
Okay. Come on. In the nighty-night time.
It's great.
Hi there. What's your name?
Rocky.
Hi, Rocky. What you got there?
Nothing.
Do your parents know you have that?
Yeah.
What did I tell you about playing with this?
Not too.
Look at me, Rocky. I don't want you going near this gun again. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir.
Now go wash up for dinner. How do you teach them not to play with guns with the goddamn shows they watch on TV make them look like toys?
Yeah, I don't know.
Carl Schmidt.
Tom Peterson.
Let's go eat.
So I had a concierge set up a picnic about 100 yards along the beach. She had no idea. She didn't know that I'd done that. So I say, oh, come on, honey, it's a gorgeous evening. Why don't we go for a walk along the beach? She was totally not interested. I practically had to twist her arm to get her to go.
I was so tired. We spent the whole day windsurfing.
I finally convinced her, right? So we're walking along the beach, and we come across this blanket and stuff. So I sit down, really casual-like, and pour myself a glass of wine, nibble a bit of cheese. She's freaking out because she thinks it's somebody else's picnic, right? So I say, very seriously, honey, it's the custom on this island. When you come across a picnic on a beach, you have to eat something. Otherwise, you're offending the locals.
Oh, my God, I would have died.
She believed me, too. I finally had to come clean, otherwise she never would have had a picnic with me. That was a great night, though. We lay there all night and stared at the stars. Talked about our dreams. Planned our life together.
That's so romantic.
It was. So, Helen, have you ever been to Hawaii?
No, I've never been anywhere. Carl was, though, when he was in the service.
Oh, yeah? You're in the Army, Carl?
Marines.
How did the two of you meet, then?
Well, Carl was stationed in town, and I was a waitress down the road from the base, and I promise you won't laugh. Yeah. He came in his uniform, and, well, I couldn't take my eyes off him.
Is the coffee ready?
Yeah. You want some coffee?
No, thanks.
Rocky! Rocky!
Rocky! You should be in bed. Rocky! Get to bed. Get to bed. Go to bed!
Kids, huh?
Yeah.
Here, let me give you a hand. Ready?
Tom, I want to show you something.
Wow. Are these real?
Yeah, I've been collecting them for years.
Wow. Thanks. These medals yours?
Some of my father's.
Whoa, cool. What is this?
It's a Viet Cong machete.
You were in Vietnam?
Yeah.
Oh man, that must have been rough. So how'd you get this?
You don't want to know. I just picked this up at a gun show. German made. This is a fine weapon. Feel the grip on that.
You know, I never held a real gun before.
Really? Well, we'll have to get you out to the gun range.
Oh, yeah, that'd be cool. Thank you.
Oh, the dinner was marvelous. Thank you.
Oh, it was easy.
Wish I could cook like that. Carl's a very lucky man. So, how long have the two of you been married?
Almost 10 years.
Just two for us.
Oh.
There must be a lot of compromises in 10 years of marriage, huh?
Yeah, that's what makes it work.
Yeah, I guess you're right, huh?
Yeah, sometimes it's not what you compromise, but why.
Thank you so much for dinner. It was so
delicious.
Good.
It was great.
Thanks for coming on such short notice.
Next time you gotta come to our place.
Okay.
Yeah?
Thank you.
Yes. Hey, Sunday, if you're not doing anything, I'm having a little get-together at my bar.
You own a bar?
Yeah, a little place in town.
Well, I don't know, because on Monday I'm leaving for business.
Hey, stay an hour or so.
Oh, it'll be fun.
okay.
Good.
Great.
Thank you. Good night. So it looks like you found yourself a new best friend, huh?
I think he's a great guy, don't you?
Yeah. He has that whole Marine thing down.
Well, that's not such a bad thing. At least you'll feel safe while I'm in L.A.
Yeah. I don't know. It just seems a whole lot rougher than your friends in Chicago.
Oh. We computer geeks be rough if we have to.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Hello.
Hey, Bun.
Monica, hi.
So, how are the new digs?
Oh, it's so beautiful out here. I can't wait for you to come see it. You're still coming, right?
Are you kidding? Of course. This time I'll steal Tom for real.
Well, sorry to disappoint you there, babe, but Tom has to fly to L.A. for 2 weeks, so...
Oh, good. Can you set up a couple of locals to buy our drinks for us?
You see, Monica, I'm a responsible married woman.
Oh, I'm only kidding. Listen, I can only stay for one night anyway.
Oh, like that's ever stopped you in the past.
Hey, I could tell Tom a few stories about the days you were single.
I have nothing to hide, and you know it.
Okay, I'm kidding.
I'll call you next week.
And let you know when I'm coming in.
Okay? I love you.
Okay, love you too.
Sandra, I am not paying for this. I look 80.
Hey, over here.
Hi.
I was hoping you guys would bail.
Oh, we needed a night out.
Did you?
Hey,
it's been a bar since we got married.
Really? Oh, well, welcome.
Carl sure goes all out for the fourth, doesn't he? Oh. Made it, huh?
Hi. Hey. How you doing?
Good to see you.
What are you drinking?
Oh, I'll get a beer.
Just a Coke.
That's all he wants, a Coke?
Oh, yeah, I'm driving, so.
Cindy! Beer and a Coke.
I'll have a Coke, too. Well, do you guys play pool?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want a game?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, great.
Okay.
Go ahead, I'll bring the drinks over.
Okay,
right.
Thank you.
How's your new neighbors?
Let's get them the drinks.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was a tough shot.
Yeah, right.
Well, you girls played a good game.
Oh, honey, the game's not over yet.
Winning is all about position. It's not about taking one shot. It's about setting up for the next one. And placing the white ball right where you want.
You forgot to mention the importance of pressure. That's why I like to take it one ball at a time.
Cindy, give me four shots for them over there.
You realize that you've got to hit the eight first, otherwise it's a scratch.
Yeah.
It's a tough shot. $20 if you can make it.
I'm just gonna go to the toilet.
Drinks for everybody. All right, folks, everything's all right. Fuck ass door. This is the last time you fuck up in here. You know what will happen next time?
I'm gonna go check on Helen, okay?
They call me at the bar.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Yeah?
Okay.
What? No, why? Help him. Yeah! Oh, let me tell you one thing. When Carl gets a look at you guys over here in the corner over
there. Oh, no. Come on, man. Come on.
You having a good time?
Yeah.
Did you get to meet anybody?
No, not really.
No.
Kind of shy that way.
Oh.
I haven't seen Helen.
She took the kids to her mother's.
Oh, well, that must be nice to have family so close.
Where's your family?
Oh, they're all back in Chicago.
Mother and father?
My mom.
Any brothers and sisters?
No, just me.
Just you?
Yeah.
You're an only child.
Yep.
Carl, I think I might need a band-aid.
How did that happen?
Broken beer bottle.
I'll take care of her.
You see?
Pretty good. Are you a nurse or something?
No. I had to take nurse's training in college, so.
You went to college, huh? You must be pretty smart. You look smart to me. Hey, look at this. I can really flip people off.
So, how did you and Carl meet?
In San Francisco. I was totally fucked up. Homeless. I was living on the streets. Carl's in town for business, and he brought me back here. He got me cleaned up. He helped me get a job. He saved my life.
Really?
But he doesn't need to talk about it. See, he saw most of the people that drink in his bar and never asked for a penny back. Hmm. Where's family?
Sounds like you know a lot about Carl.
Oh, I know everything about Carl. I know what he likes. I know what he doesn't like. I know things about Carl even pretty little Helen doesn't know.
Like what?
Well, I know after he gets really mad, like Why are you so interested in Carl? Aren't you married?
Yeah, I am, and I don't have that kind of interest in Carl.
Yeah, me neither.
Tom, listen! Tom, come here! I want you to meet somebody. This is Matt. You guys bailed me out of more shit than you can imagine.
What? You hell of a friend.
No, I'm a bell bottom.
What, are you fucking blind? Can't you read that?
Oh! Disgusting!
That's disgusting! Come here, I'll show you. Come here, come here. Come here. Right here, disgusting. Right here.
Lori, she's just showing me.
I want to go home now.
Oh, come on, the party just started.
Knock it off.
Come on, Tom, you need too much to drink. Where are you going? Come on, Carl. Yeah, go.
Thanks, Carl.
Josie, take off.
I want to go home. Completely humiliating. I can't even believe you'd embarrass me like that.
Well, I was just sitting there. She climbed up on top of me. What was I supposed to do?
Gee, I don't know, Tom. Maybe say I'm married, get off?
She knew I was married, Lori. Come on, everybody was just having fun. It's not like I was sleeping with her.
Gee, you're right, Tom. It's not like you're sleeping with me either.
I know pity is out of the question. And believe me, I'm paying the price right now for every stupid thing I did last night. But is there any chance at all for breakfast?
Breakfast.
How you feeling this morning?
Great.
You gotta be careful when you mix drinks.
I guess I made a bit of a fool of myself last night.
No, you were just having some fun, that's all.
Listen, Carl, could you keep an eye on Lori while I'm gone? She's...
Don't worry about it. You have a safe trip.
Hey, Rocky. What are you doing?
Rocky? Rocky, what?
Hi.
Hey, Lori.
Hi.
Rocky, what have you been doing now?
Same.
Don't you lie to me.
Oh, I think he just wants to play, huh?
actually, I'm glad I ran into you. I meant to apologize about Carl's party getting out of hand.
Oh, no. We had a good time, really. Although, we didn't really see much of you there.
You know, I got this weird stomach ache, and I just decided to take the kids to my mom's. I didn't want to be a drag. I should have said goodbye. I was really rude.
Oh, no. No, I understand. Listen, Tom has had to leave for 2 weeks, so I was wondering if maybe we could get together and talk. You know, kind of like a girl's night out, you know, just to get you away from all these little ones.
Yeah, I'd love it.
Okay.
Let's talk later in the week.
Definitely. Okay.
I gotta go. I'll talk to you later.
Bye.
Bye.
My dad says he'll be at peace.
Rocky! Rocky, come on!
Hi.
Hi.
Is it all right if I come in?
Yeah, come on in.
Wow. You did some job with this place, huh?
Thanks.
It looks great.
Thanks. Can I get you coffee?
Or... No, I gotta get over to the bar. I just wanted to stop by to let you know that if there's anything you need while Tom's away, don't hesitate to call me.
I'm sure I'll be okay.
Okay. Oh, yeah, Friday night we're having a 4th of July party. You know, some of the people you met at the bar will be there.
Oh, I'll think about it.
I hope you can make it.
Okay.
Okay. And I mean it. Anything you need, you call me.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Rocky? Rocky, come on, get in here. Hurry up. Hurry up, sweetie. There you go. Oh, buckle up. You know how to do that. All righty.
I'm so sorry. God, I hate it when Tom does that to me. Where are you guys headed?
I'm just taking the kids to my mom's house.
Oh, isn't tonight's Carl's 4th of July party? You're not going to be here for it?
I didn't know you were going to go.
Oh.
Dylan, I think, has that same stomach thing, so I'm really not sure. I'm just going to take her to my mom's, you know, and then hopefully I'll be able to be back. So I'm really sorry, but I gotta get going.
I understand.
Okay.
Oh, hey, listen, I'm still waiting for a ladies' night out, all right?
Okay, that would be great.
Okay.
Thank you. Buckle up, sweetheart. Okay.
Party. Carl says come on over.
No, thank you.
He said don't take no for an answer.
Well, that's the only answer I've got, sorry.
Keeping calm? What do you got over there?
Report a prowler. 11620 Old Mill Road.
Someone's on their way.
Okay. I'm pretty sure that they went into that house over there, too.
Really? Okay. I want you to just take a deep breath and relax. I'm gonna go over there right now and find out what the hell's going on, all right? Thank you.
trying. It's all right. These things are gonna happen.
What happened?
Well, I talked with Carl, and he agrees with you.
He does?
Oh, yeah. Apparently, he saw someone, too, prowling around your yard. Then his friend, you know, what's his name, Deacon, he came over, took a look around, didn't see anything. You see, this sort of stuff happens around here a lot, especially on the 4th of July. I'm sure whoever it was is long gone by now, but I don't want you to worry. Carl says your husband's out of town for a couple of weeks. Is that right?
Yeah, yes.
Hey, I know how that can be. But listen, would you like me to hang around a little bit? You know, just until you calm down.
No, that's fine.
You sure? That's my job, you know. I'm on your payroll, so to speak. I'm here to serve you.
No, you know what? I'm gonna try to go to sleep.
Oh, yeah, sure. Sounds good to me. I'd like to get a little shut-eye myself. But don't worry about a thing. I'll keep a close eye on the place for you. And, I'll catch you later. Sweet dreams.
I'll do it all myself. I just want you to kiss me. If you make a sound, I'm gonna slit your throat to the back of your head.
You're dead.
Look at me!
For those cuts, okay?
I'm scared. Oh, I need someplace where he won't find us. Okay, I will. Always like this. I do things that upset him and he gets frustrated.
This is not your fault, Lily.
I went to my mom's and she said I should try to come back and work things out. He just, you know, since we had the kids, I do things that he just loses patience. He doesn't mean it.
Helen! Come on out, honey. Come on out, honey. I'm sorry. Come on, I'm sorry. Come on, honey. The kids need you. I need you. Come on out.
No, no, you're staying here tonight.
I have to hide. I still.
I'm here, okay?
The Rabbit family was so excited about their beautiful new home. A family of goblins were their neighbors to be. So they ran and ran and ran until the evil Papa Goblin could no longer harm them. Sorry about last night. Helen left me this morning. I don't know when she's coming back, if she's coming back at all. But you know that already. Isn't that what you two talked about last night?
We talked about a lot of things.
And she told you that I hit her.
She didn't have to.
You know, after the baby was born, Helen had a complete mental breakdown. They took her away in a straitjacket, screaming and yelling. She tried to kill me with a kitchen knife. There's two sides to every story, Lori.
Just assume that he did enter your house the way you say he did. Was anything taken?
Well, no.
Were you accosted, threatened, or harmed in any way?
His wife was.
Well, then that's up to her, isn't it? to come down here and file a complaint?
I told you I heard a gunshot. I mean, he could have murdered her for all you know.
Did you see a murder?
That doesn't mean he didn't do it.
No, it also means that there's no reason to think he did. I can't execute a man for, you know, arguing with his wife.
I just want you to talk to her, okay? I just need to know that she's okay. That's all I'm asking. And then I promise I'll mind my own business, okay? Just whatever you want.
Okay. If it will make you feel any better, I'll go talk to her. How's that?
Thank you very much. Thank you.
But after I do, I'm gonna hold you to that promise.
Okay.
How's it coming?
Why do you want a lock on this door? What do you have, a monkey problem?
No, we're building a deck out here eventually.
Okay, that should about do it.
How secure is this?
It's the best lock money could buy. Of course, a chain is only as strong as its weakest link.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means if they don't come in the door, they'll come in the window. By the way, we have a special on window locks today. Okay, you're all set now. Houdini couldn't get in here without a key.
Thank you. I feel much safer now.
Although I can't imagine why you need locks in this neighborhood. Everybody knows everybody. Hey, Carl! How you doing?
Hey! Give her a break, don't rip her off! Friday night, there's a poker game!
Yeah, I'll be there. How'd you want to pay for that? Are you okay? Mrs. Peterson? Mrs. Peterson?
to. I couldn't get my keys to work.
What are you doing here?
Oh, you sounded like you missed me. They closed down for the weekend, so I thought I'd catch a late flight back and spend some time with my wife in our new house.
We got a call about a prowler. Is everything okay?
Wake up. Wake up. What's wrong?
What's wrong, honey? What's wrong?
I thought you were...
What? You thought it was what?
I thought you were Carl.
Carl? Why would you think that?
Hey, Tom, come on in. Can I get you a beer?
Look, I need to speak with you for a minute, Carl.
What's up?
I understand you came into my house. Uninvited.
What do you mean?
I mean, you came into my house. Our bedroom. While my wife was sleeping.
Is that what Laurie said?
Yeah.
Vernon, you know Tom, Laurie's husband.
Yeah, sure. Lucky man if I ever saw one. Hey, how's she feeling? She was a little uncomfortable being alone while you were gone.
We have a misunderstanding here. Lori's a little confused. She seems to think I came into their house uninvited. And that is just not true.
She's just not used to being alone. That's the thing.
I understand. I've seen this kind of thing before, you know. Anxiety. Messes with your head. Yeah, new house. A few strange noises at night. Pretty soon, every shadow starts to look like a killer, right?
Yeah.
You remember that film, Psycho? Hey, man, I couldn't take a shower for months after that.
Yeah.
I'll have Helen talk to her. She goes through the same thing when I'm away.
Look, Carl. I'm sorry. This isn't your fault. I should have expected something like this. I thought she'd be okay with it, but I guess it was too soon to leave her alone up here.
What do you mean?
Lori was, violated.
Oh, yeah?
It was right before we got married. Out in a parking lot. She was at a bar celebrating with a friend, and,
Sorry to hear that, Tom.
Yeah, that's terrible. Jesus.
Hard on her.
I want you to have this.
Lori wouldn't touch that, Carl.
You both will feel a lot safer if you have this in the house. Take it.
Take it, pal.
Take it.
What's that?
Something Carl gave me. A new CD player.
I don't believe you.
What do you want me to do, Lori? I went over there and I told him what you said.
And?
He says that you invited him in.
He's lying, Tom. He broke in here while I was sleeping.
Well, that's not how Sheriff Crank sees it.
What does that mean? Was he over there?
Lori, you've been under a lot of stress lately. I've been away. It's a new house.
What about the gunshot and the digging? What was that? You didn't even ask him, did you?
I can't walk into the man's house and accuse him of murder, Lori.
Oh, well, you can walk into our house and accuse me of lying.
I didn't say that you were lying.
You didn't have to. Enjoy your new CD player.
I want you to go back with me tomorrow night. I don't want to leave you alone in this house.
Monica's coming Monday.
Look, I know how you feel about guns, Lori.
Where did that come from?
It doesn't matter where it came from. I just think that we'll sleep better while I'm gone. No one's here.
Tom, you know how I feel about guns. I can't even believe you brought that into this house.
It's for your protection, Lori.
It's for killing, Tom. There's no other purpose.
I'm not asking you to shoot anyone. It's a deterrent.
My father was killed by his own gun using it as a deterrent.
I know that, Lori. Will you just try to understand
me? Who are you? You bring a gun into this house and then you lie about it. What else does he have you doing?
It's not about Carl.
The hell it's not, and the scary part is that you can't even see it. No, I want that gun out of this house before you leave.
We'll talk about this when I get back. All set to leave.
Have a good trip.
Lori, this is ridiculous. Can't we just... I'll see you Friday, okay? Give my best to Monica.
Hey. How are you?
So he takes his tongue out of my ear. He's like this former football player, you know, who reminds me of a Swedish logger. Oh. And then he whispers in my ear, let's do it right here.
Oh, no, please tell me you didn't do it. Please.
Oh, I was going to. And then the seatbelt sign came on, you know, and so I just gave him this little hand job and he's thanking me profusely. It was really sweet. You okay?
I don't know.
I'm going crazy. My neighbor, the man beats his wife.
You saw him hit her?
Yeah, more than once. I don't know, and I know every single time he's doing it because it cranks the music up in his house.
Oh, my God.
Monica, she came over here last Friday night. I think he just finished, like, beating the crap out of her. I think she was trying to leave, and then he talked her into staying, and I don't know if it's just me going crazy, but I think I heard a gunshot that night, and I haven't seen her since.
You think he killed her?
I don't know. I think he killed her and then, like, buried her in his own backyard.
Did you call the police?
Right, yeah, a lot of good that did. He's best friends with the sheriff.
Oh, well, now all we need is Angela Lansbury to show up. Oh, is that him? Well, he looks like a killer.
No, he's the one that's driving.
Oh, driving. Oh, he's kind of cute. I was talking about the scary-looking one.
Well, that's his friend Deacon, and I'm sure he has his share of buried wives somewhere.
Buns, why don't we get the sheriff to do a little investigating back there?
I just told you, they're best friends. I mean, he could be in on it for all I know.
Well, now, you know, you haven't learned anything from me, have you? Man's best friend is a dog. For reasons I will now show you. Where's the phone, honey?
Kitchen. Hi, thank you so much for coming over so quickly.
Hey, I'm glad you called. What can I do for you?
Sheriff. Hi, come on in.
This is Monica. She's the one who called.
How you doing?
Hi. She knows I've always had a thing for cops. Sheriffs, they're the same thing as cops, aren't they?
Yeah, well, we're on the same side, I guess. At least most of the time.
Oh, God, I guess it's just like a uniform thing, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, feel this. It's like a rock. Oh, oh, my God, you must work out every day.
Well, you know, I try to keep myself in some kind of shape.
Oh, gosh, I can't imagine anybody screwing with you. Bad guys, I mean. How about that coffee, Buns?
Yes, I think it's done.
Why do you call her Buns?
Oh, come on, Vernon. Don't tell me you haven't noticed her ass. She got that nickname a long time before she met Tom.
Yeah? Well, what do they call you?
Good.
Ha ha! Okay, you said black, right?
Yeah, right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You know, maybe, maybe we should talk about exactly why I'm here.
Well, I was wondering if you had talked to Helen.
Me? No, I haven't talked to her. Not yet.
Why don't we just go talk to her right now?
Is she home?
Well, I think she's in the backyard, isn't she, Lori?
Yeah.
Well, actually, nobody's seen her since her husband shot her.
Wait a minute, slow down. Nobody saw a shooting, did they?
No, but I saw him digging in his backyard in the middle of the night. I mean, that's kind of a strange time to be doing a little gardening, don't you think?
I bet you found yourself doing things at strange times before, haven't you?
Oh, you got me, don't you? So, what would it take to get you to go out there and poke around a little bit?
Poke around? Back where?
Oh, Sheriff, let's keep this between you and me.
All righty. You want me to do something? Bring me a body.
What does that mean?
I think it means we have to find a body.
Monica, no, I can't let you do this.
Oh, God, are you kidding? I don't think you could stop me.
Okay, no, what if we get caught?
We're not gonna get caught, okay? And if his wife is dead, that makes him single, and I can handle it.
Okay, you know what? This is serious, okay? You don't know what he's like.
Relax, Buns. He can't do anything as long as you're watching.
Okay, just promise me. Promise me you'll dig until you find something, then just get out of there.
Okay, Mom. Come on. Planting your trees. It was just like a joke. We thought it would be funny, and you'd come out and you'd see your trees planted, and you wouldn't know who or why. Or we were just fooling around. It was just a joke. You must be Carl, right?
Let her go, okay? It was my idea. Carl, just put the gun down.
Get out of here.
God. Well, I thought he was gonna kill me.
I'm so sorry, Monica. She's sorry.
You know, he's crazy, Buns. He's like, get in the car and move to Arizona, crazy.
No, I'm calling the police.
Yeah, well, we tried that, remember? And besides, like, we were the one trespassing.
What am I supposed to do, huh?
Well, you're coming with me in the morning. That's what you're gonna do. You can stay with me in Seattle until Tom gets home. Do you have a bottle opener?
Monica, time to wake up. Rise and shine, girl.
Hi, this is Monica. If you want a call back, leave a message worth returning.
It's Buns. I can't believe you left without telling me. Okay, just call me as soon as you get this, all right? Hi, I'd like to book a flight, please.
Okay, just a second. I'm bringing up the reservation screen. Can I get you to hold, please?
Okay, thank you. Helen?
Lake Sammamish, 1992. Caught 6 rainbows. You and your girlfriend were right. He did bury something back there.
I knew it.
His dog.
What?
His dog, Wolf. He buried his dog in his backyard.
How do you know that?
Because he told us.
He's lying. What about Helen?
Helen's visiting her mother.
Well, did you go there? I mean, did you see her?
Look, Lori, Carl Schmidt is a friend of mine, an old friend of mine, and so is Helen. And there's no law against a marriage gone bad. So maybe you should just go home and keep your damn curtains closed. And maybe try to mind your own business.
You know, it's a little hard when your neighbor murders his wife and his friends don't seem to notice. Oh, by the way, my friend Monica, she seems to have disappeared too.
What? What are these?
Oh, those? Those are Helen's keys. I guess she doesn't need them wherever she is, right?
What's on your mind, Vernon?
Well, reason I stopped by, Carl, is, shit, man, I hate to even bring this up. It's so crazy. But, you know that Peterson woman? She thinks that you shot Helen and buried her in your yard. We ain't talking black market scams, Carl, and we ain't talking miscommunication. This woman is obsessed. She's convinced that you killed your wife. I don't think that you can afford murder, pal.
Where'd you get those?
Lori Peterson gave them to me. They're Helen's keys, and she's not at her mother's. My deputy checked. The kids were there, but no Helen. We gotta have a serious talk, buddy.
Get my coat.
Buried his dog in his backyard.
Leave it.
Ha ha ha!